Hi, how are you? I hope you're having a great day. We had our last Christmas get together over the weekend. Due to the weather conditions around Christmas, two of our get-togethers were canceled and changed to different days. We had a great time at both family events. I love my family. What a joy it was to be with them. And I consider all of you to be family too. And this time we spend together is a joy to me. Thank you for being here. I hope that this message today brings a bit of hope that researchers are discovering what is happening in our bodies. So here we go. Neurotransmitters send nerve impulses to the brain and from the brain to the spinal cord, which results in everywhere else in the body. These are chemical messengers and substances that are released at the end of a nerve fiber. A nerve fiber is the axon of a neuron. The messages travel to a nerve impulse through a fluid-filled space, dispersing across the synapse, causing the transfer of the impulse to another nerve fiber, muscle fiber, or some other structure, like a gland cell. When neurotransmitters are out of balance, especially those that are believed to produce chronic pain, we will experience an array of symptoms. We've talked about the imbalance of serotonin, known to be out of balance in fibromyalgia, and dopamine in restless legs. And then there's endorphins, known to play a role in our perception of pain experienced by fibromyalgia patients. These chemical messengers help us feel sensations, move our limbs, keep our heart beating, help us think, and take in and respond to all information our body receives from other internal parts of our body and our environment. Once a neurotransmitter lands on and binds to that specific receptor on a target cell, it triggers a change or action in the target cell, like a release of hormones or a muscle contraction. So nerves are involved in everything we do, everything we think and feel. Billions of nerve cells exist in our bodies. And once that neurotransmitter delivers its message, it must be cleared away and is usually reabsorbed to be reused, broken down, or it fades away. Today, we'll talk about glutamate, GABA, and histamine, three neurotransmitters that are known to be involved in fibromyalgia and potentially in ME/CFS. When neurotransmitters are out of whack, they can cause problems in our bodies. Some of these problems are too much or not enough of one or more neurotransmitter that is produced or released. The receiver cell receptor may not work properly and not be able to receive the signal. Inflammation can cause the receptor to not take up enough neurotransmitter. Neurotransmitters are reabsorbed too quickly, or enzymes limit the number of neurotransmitters from reaching their target cells. Or existing diseases cause them to malfunction or to not function properly. and then more disease can occur. When there is a known disease in the body, medications can block the release of certain neurotransmitters from a nerve cell. Glutamate is the most abundant and important excitatory neurotransmitter in the brain and is necessary for proper brain functioning. Nearly all excitatory neurons in the central nervous system are glutamatergic, and it is estimated that over half of all brain synapses release this chemical. It is an essential amino acid, which means our body produces it mostly from glucose. It doesn't cross the blood-brain barrier and must be synthesized from local precursors such as glutamine in the central nervous system. Excitatory neurotransmitters are chemical messengers that excite or stimulate a nerve cell so it can receive critical information. It stimulates our brain to learn new information or form new memories. When there are elevated concentrations of glutamate released due to neural injury, it is toxic to neurons, and that's called excitotoxicity. Glutamate is considered a stimulant, and so too much of this stimulant can become what's called an excitotoxin, meaning it overexcites neurons until that neuron is damaged or it dies. Although glutamate is considered one of the main sources of energy in our brain cells, if you have too much, you might experience hyperalgesia, what we know as our pain amplification. And in fibromyalgia research, abnormally high levels of glutamate have been found in a part of the brain called the insula or insular cortex. This area of the brain is involved in pain and emotion, key components of fibromyalgia. It's also involved in sensory perception, motor skills, anxiety, eating disorders, increased itching, poor focus, sleep disorders, restless legs, and addiction. And for an individual with type 1 diabetes, glutamate is linked to depression and low cognitive function. Elevated glutamate occurs as the stress hormone, cortisol, triggers a release of glutamate in the brain. Stress from physical, mental, or emotional situations upsets the body's normal homeostatic balance, and elevated thyroid hormone levels may also raise blood glutamate levels. If the blood-brain barrier is dysfunctional and leaky, elevated blood glutamate can be problematic for the brain. And excess glutamate is believed to cause anxiety, restlessness, and ADHD-like symptoms, such as the inability to focus. One study suggests that lowering glutamate levels can reduce pain. It suggests to avoid foods with glutamate, such as MSG, a flavor enhancer in foods, consume magnesium supplements, don't put aspartame in your food or drink, and eat more magnesium-rich foods like leafy greens, dry beans, and whole grains. And what can be confusing is that cabbage, asparagus, and broccoli are high in glutamate. I love those vegetables, so I'll probably continue to eat them because, on the other hand, these vegetables can lower cholesterol and are good for eye health. But eating foods with MSG or monosodium glutamate can be eliminated or, you know, lower your amount of MSG more easily, in my opinion. MSG is an amino acid called glutamic acid. We will find all kinds of foods with glutamic acid in it, but MSG, the food additive, is a synthetic glutamate. Flavored chips and crackers, instant noodles, salad dressings, hot dogs, and cold cats have this additive. And not all packaged foods will list this on the packaging ingredient list. It's not required by the FDA. I don't think we'll be able to completely avoid MSG. So you'll just have to look at the whole picture. However, in ME/CFS, some researchers believe that glutamate is low, so the brain isn't getting enough stimulation. And then this lack of glutamate results in low energy, mental exhaustion, concentration problems, and insomnia. And other researchers stated that those levels are the same as fibromyalgia, high glutamate and low GABA. Let's talk about GABA. Glutamate is needed to make GABA, gamma aminobutyric acid, which has a calming effect on the brain, the opposite of glutamate. It's involved in sleep, relaxation, anxiety regulation, and muscle function. In fibromyalgia, GABA is believed to be low or insufficiently used. Because of the close relationship between glutamate and GABA, however, a deficiency may resemble those of excess glutamate. It's possible that increasing glutamate may also increase GABA. And there are drugs on the market that some people with fibromyalgia or ME/CFS that may be altering the level of GABA. These are called agonists, and they increase activity by stimulating receptors, but they don't cause neurotransmitter levels to rise. These agonists are benzodiazepines, GHB, and non-benzodiazepine hypnotics like Lunesta and Ambien. So what can you do? It's recommended to do yoga. It's a relaxing form of exercise that people really love. Studies have shown that histamine levels in immune cells, called mast cells, may be dysregulated. Histamine is another excitatory neurotransmitter that is released by stress and is elevated in fibromyalgia and ME/CFS. It's involved with the immune system, the skin and digestive tract, but it also plays a major role in wakefulness, blood pressure, satiety, and numerous brain functions. Some individuals don't process histamine well because of the DAO gene variants. Others have a diet high in histamines, like wine, champagne, beer, kombucha, kefir, vinegar, and yogurt. Everyone has an abundance of mast cells in their skin, but fibromyalgia patients have 5 to 14 times more histamine in their skin compared to people without fibromyalgia. Now, we need these mast cells in our skin to provide an immune defense against pathogens, but an abundance creates itchy skin. And in the rest of the body, high histamine release impairs sleep quality in fibromyalgia and ME/CFS. This histamine also perpetuates the release of substance P and glutamate, causing chronic tissue irritation. Magnesium, calcium, and vitamin C may help lower histamine and alleviate symptoms. And also, it's important to decrease your stress levels. So I hope you learned something. I send you gentle hugs and support. Love you. Our pain and or insular receptor. It's a flavor. Is an amino acid with, it's possible to some individuals, others have a high wine champagne release impair. And there's the ever-present alleviation of, and there's the ever-present stress, and there's the, and also, mm-hmm.